Pei Mei versus Bolo Yeung. Which character would win in a fight? Hi there and welcome to our channel. Have you ever wondered how some of the most notable martial arts movie stars would fare in a real fight against one another? Well, that's what we love to explore in our videos. So today, we've got two of the most exciting martial arts characters going up against each other. It's Pei Mei from Kill Bill versus the legendary Bolo Yeung. What do you think? How would these two dudes fare in combat? We're about to find out in this video, so be sure to watch till the end. Before we begin, kindly hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click on the notification bell so you never miss any of our upcoming exciting matchups. And with that done, let's turn our attention to Pei Mei. Pei Mei was the legendary Kung Fu master in Kill Bill. The 1,000-year-old master tutored Bill himself, L Driver, and Beatrix Kiddo. A profound master of the Pei Mei and Eagle's Claw styles of Kung Fu, he was also the tutor behind the devastating 3-inch punch and the 5-point palm exploding heart technique, which he specifically taught Beatrix. No doubt, Pei Mei was a super talented Kung Fu master, a man who reached the very heights of Kung Fu mastery. He was so good that it was virtually impossible to defeat him in combat. Little wonder L Driver didn't bother to take that route to bring him down. Instead, she poisoned Pei Mei in revenge for plucking out her eyes. But who exactly was Pei Mei? As a Kung Fu master, Pei Mei was primarily a teacher of the art. But his approach to teaching his students could best be described as unorthodox. In a bid to humble his students early on when they came to learn from him, Pei Mei would mercilessly chastise and punish them if he so much as perceived a scent of defiance around them. For him, that was the only way he could mold their body, soul, and mind to conform to the essence of the secrets of Kung Fu. But despite his brash approach to raising his students, beneath that brutal exterior, Pei Mei was an open-minded person. While training Beatrix, Pei Mei was impressed by her sheer tenacity and began to look after her in a capacity that was more than just a tutor. He cared for Beatrix deeply enough to give her the most prized gift of all, teaching her the revered 5-point palm exploding heart technique. In his centuries of training students, Pei Mei had never taught any student this technique. Beatrix was the first. She had proven herself worthy of the honor through her intense dedication and her streak of meeting her master's expectations. In the end, Beatrix would use the 5-point palm exploding heart technique to ultimately defeat her nemesis, Bill. As a fighter, Pei Mei was a supreme martial artist. In fact, one could say that his martial arts skills were beyond human capacity. He is reputed to be capable of single-handedly killing 60 monks at a go. Beyond that, he is the creator and master of the 5-point palm exploding heart technique, one of the most deadly kung fu moves in the world. Pei Mei possesses superhuman speed, agility, and dexterity. He was an expert at dodging sword strikes and had the balance of a cat, and he was capable of maintaining his balance while standing on the back of a blade. Then there's his extended longevity. Pei Mei had mastered the secret of having perfect human health. And were it not for L's vengeful antics, Mei would have lived for several more centuries. At the time of his death, he was said to be well over 1,000 years old. Bolo Yeung was a character from the iconic Bruce Lee movie, Enter the Dragon. The man behind the character actually goes by the name Yang Zi, but following his impressive performance in the movie, Enter the Dragon, the name Bolo Yeung has stuck ever since. For this hypothetical fight, however, we will be judging Bolo Yeung, the actor, based on his on-screen performances as Bolo, his other iconic character roles, and his personal life. Bolo was born in Guangdong, China on July 3, 1946. He was just 10 years old when he took up martial arts training in Canton. There, Bolo underwent kung fu training under 7 different kung fu masters. Following his years of kung fu training, Bolo took interest in bodybuilding. Later on, he would become the Mr. Hong Kong Bodybuilding Champion, a title he held for 10 years. As a result of his very intimidating physique, Bolo would be offered the chance to play several roles in martial arts films portraying the bad guy. At that time, he was working with the Shaw brothers, starring in films such as The Heroic Ones, Deadly Duo, and Angry Guest. While filming a Winston cigarette commercial, Bolo met Bruce Lee, and the two men became really good friends. The friendship came with some special favors for Bolo, as he was invited by Bruce Lee to star in the film Enter the Dragon. In the film, Bolo served as a stuntman alongside Sammo Hung and Jackie Chan. He also played the role of Bolo, the sadistic bodyguard of one of the lead characters, Han. This was where the name Bolo stuck for Yeung. During filming, Bolo and Bruce Lee worked very closely on technique training as the two continued to deepen their friendship. Bolo's breakout movie was the film Bloodsport, which he starred in alongside Jean-Claude Van Damme. The two men also became friends during filming and once again collaborated in the movie Double Impact. Bolo would later go on to star in several films, spanning a hugely successful career in Hong Kong martial arts films. Now that we've met our two fighters, let's make our way into the arena to find out which of these two legendary characters will come out on top. To decide the winner, as always, we'll be judging each fighter across 4 major categories. These are fighting pedigree, physique, skill, and improvisation. For each category, each fighter will be awarded a maximum of 10 points. In the end, the fighter with the higher cumulative points will be declared the winner. All right, let's begin. Fighting pedigree. This one needs no real explanation, to be honest. Pei Mei stands head and shoulders above Bolo in this department. Mei is practically a kung fu demigod and the creator of one of the most, if not the most, deadly signature moves in all of kung fu. There's just no comparing his fighting pedigree with Bolo Yeung. So, sorry Bolo, it's an astonishing perfect 10 for Master Pei Mei and 6 for Bolo. Physique. Bolo Yeung stood at an average 5 feet 6 inches, weighing about 70 kilograms in his prime. And make no mistake, that was 70 kilograms of lean muscle. On the other hand, Pei Mei is a 1,000-year-old kung fu master. We don't have details about his exact height and weight, but he's not likely to be much taller or heavier than Bolo, despite being in good physical condition. Bolo clearly has the edge here, so 9 points to Bolo and 5 to Pei Mei. Skills. There's no way Bolo trumps Pei Mei in the skill department. Absolutely no way. Just one execution of Pai Mei's 5-point palm exploding heart technique, and this bout will be over. That's how much skill Pei Mei has in his arsenal. This one is straightforward. 10 points to Pei Mei and 7 points to Bolo Yeung. Improvisation. As a supreme kung fu master, Pei Mei is well-versed in a plethora of secret skills and techniques, many of which will be unknown to Bolo, leaving him at the risk of being stunned in this combat at any moment. As a result, Pei Mei takes this round yet again. 9 points to him and 6 to Bolo. The verdict. So, what do we have here? With a total of 34 points, Pei Mei absolutely blows Bolo out of the water, limiting his final score to only 28 points. The only way Bolo is getting past Pei Mei is to poison him just like L did. On the battle floor, Bolo stands no chance against Pei Mei. Do you agree with our verdict? Let's know what you think in the comment section. Thanks for watching till the end. We'll see you in our next video.